Hi, I'm Lena Dunham.
I'm Leslie Arfin.
We're here at Amoeba Records. We're very excited about it for a DVD signing of my movie Tiny Furniture.
And I'm DJing for DVD signing.
It's a pretty
DJ Leslie Arfin.
It's a pretty sweet hookup.
Look, we met. You know, I thought, hey, you know, this is a funny chick. This is nice. This is easy. You know, I'm not worrying about whether or not we're gonna, you know, make out or some fucking nonsense. You know, it's no big whoop. And that's how it's supposed to be, you know?
Yeah.
By the way, you do sweat the bed.
Anyway, we are here to do What's in My Bag. They're baskets, but...
Yeah, they're not actually bags. But the first thing we put in was this album by the Lemonheads. It's a shame about Ray.
We love the Lemonheads. We have a good friend named Jesse Peretz, who was the original bassist for the Lemonheads.
True.
He's done a lot of things since, but we think that's a hot piece of trivia about him.
Most importantly, he's one of the directors on Girls,
which is the TV show that we both work on.
I think that I may be the voice of my generation, or at least a voice of a generation.
Yeah, and he also directed that movie, Brothers.
Our idiot brother, also known as Brothers. For those who know, it's called Brothers.
Okay.
This is one of Leslie and my shared passions. It's a cartoon called Home Movies.
And it's so fun.
It's so fun. It's about like dictatorial 8-year-old film directors.
Action. Hi.
Hi!
Cut. Not bad.
It's good!
And their demented soccer coach.
Nobody's getting an A because we suck. So let's start with the bidding. Who'll give me $5 for a B+?
And put upon mothers.
Do you see the firemen? Okay, and do you see that the kitchen is...
Oh, for Pete's sake, Paula. Hi, Paula. How was your fire? I'm getting a divorce.
And it's just a delight through and through.
If you never thought you could get a crush on like a...
Cartoon!
8-year-old cartoon character.
No.
You'd be wrong.
I kind of already knew because I got a crush on that fox that was Robin Hood. But this enhanced it.
This is another scary movie that we both love so much.
We're finding out so much about each other as close friends from doing What's My Bag together. This movie's incredible.
Yeah, people don't know.
The Sixth Sense can go eat a baguette. This is amazing.
What have you done with my daughter?
Are you mad? I am your daughter.
The others is spine-tingling, chill-worthy.
We'll make you ask big questions.
Yes.
And also...
And the costumes are great, too.
And Nicole Kidman, incredible, and great kid performances. There's no reason not to watch this movie.
I'm buying it.
Yep.
Wait, can we talk about this for a second? It's $99.
And we would get it, but it's just gonna blow our whole budget.
But
that being said, how can you resist this lineup?
It meant a lot to Lena.
A lot.
I never saw it. I remember when it was on.
Allie, truthfully, have you ever used your sexuality to gain a business advantage?
Me?
No.
I could tell you a spoiler alert about this character and where his life is headed, but I'm not going to.
Wait, you're not?
He dies.
In real life?
In the show.
Oh.
But you know what's great about her being on it is this is Vonda Shepard, whose entire role in the show is she just plays a song in the cafe at the end of every show.
That's it?
And I always get her confused with Shonda Rhimes, so I was like, oh my god, that woman who played the guitar at the end of Ally McBeal invented Grey's Anatomy? Not true.
Wait, is there like
Vonda
a baby
Shepard,
in every
Rhimes.
Episode?
A gaby?
No, just a singing baby.
Girl, you just don't realize what you do to me.
Yeah, there's the dancing
in every episode.
Not
that's
every
why
episode.
I didn't want to watch it because that freaked me out. This album, 69 Love Songs by the Magnetic Field.
This is the epitaph for my heart.
I love this album. It's like basically three albums in one. And Stephen Merritt, although he is a D-bag, because I saw the documentary, I hate watched it, it was unbearable. He's a very amazing musician. I shouldn't put that negative energy out into the world.
Well, a lot of complex people can make great music. Consider The Breeders, for example.
I'm sure Kim Deal is the nicest person ever.
But
Kelly Deal does knitwear.
She does knitwear?
I think.
I literally thought you were going to say heroin, and then it turned into knitwear.
She used to. No, I think that they're into crafts now, and they both live in Ohio with their mom. Don't quote me on these things, but I'm just...
Don't hold me to them.
Right.
Yeah. We both love Fiona Apple. We're both huge Fiona Apple fans.
Oh, yeah, that's my favorite Fiona Apple.
Hunger hurts, and I want them so bad. Oh, it kills, because I know I'm a messy.
Yeah, it's a great one.
What's your favorite song on it?
Paper Bag.
Me too.
Yeah.
Twinsies.
Done.
This is one of our favorite shows.
It's amazing. We have a favorite quote from Serena's Candy. If wishes and butts were clusters of nuts, we'd all have a bowl of granola.
Her name's Suki. She's a Japanese silky, hand-trained. She'll eat grapes out of anywhere I put them. Anywhere.
Remember
so
when he's
good.
Like, retards don't own the night, nobody does. Do you remember that one?
There's not an episode of it that's not hilarious.
This is Lena's pick. Sweet November. She couldn't resist.
No, it was like 49, that and Bounce. It's like, how do you walk away from that? That's beautiful.
It is.
I feel like watching movies like Sweet November is going to make me more comfortable with my own mortality and know what to kind of love to reach for.
Marry me, Sarah.
I've met
Keanu Reeves
once.
Is that the one where they're
like,
they die, and then they talk to each other from different cabins? Is there like a cabin?
That's the lake house.
Oh.
Yeah. I met Keanu Reeves one time, and it was as good as I thought it would be.
Really?
Which is rare, you can say that.
Yeah.
I mean, it wasn't like we didn't hang hard, but I did ask him if I could take a picture of us with my iPhone, and he said yes, and in the picture he went like this.
We picked out the Gang Gang Dance album because this is a band that's happening right now that we both really love and
really
awesome.
Happening. They are on the soundtrack of Girls. Love them.
They are?
Mm-hmm.
Awesome.
Really good. A hot scene. Gang Gang, I'm not going to say which one, but it's a sex scene.
Another musical movie that I really love, and fun fact, Xanadu is filmed right in my neighborhood. I found out the other night there was like a whole mural of her roller skating and she comes out of the mural. And that mural is in fact on Beverly, since it's not there anymore, but I just thought that was really cool. And also it reminds me of my sister and I love her.
I have Leslie's fleece in my bag, which I'll just pass, which I'd like to buy.
Thanks.
We wanted a little Bjork.
Oh yeah,
Army
because
of
we
me.
Love that. Song Hyper Ballad.
Yeah, and Army of Me is
and
good
Army.
Too.
And if you complain once more, you meet them, Army of Me.
This is a classic. And then I was just reading Catherine Deneuve's journals in which she just, it's an amazing book, it's really well written, but there's 40 pages of just her talking pure shit about Bjork. Just
amazing.
Being like, Bjork was a toxic diva on the set of Dancer in the Dark. I can't believe she behaved this way. It's
a really
amazing.
Sad movie.
It's a really sad movie. She's like, Bjork couldn't handle the scene where she got hung. She couldn't handle it so much that she didn't come to set.
This is the next to last song.
That Bjork.
Yeah. Troublemaker.
She won't be appearing on Girls anytime soon. Don't tell her I said that.
unless she wants to come, in which case it's fine.
Yeah.
Thanks so much for having us here at Amoeba. It's like a cathedral.
I love Amoeba so much.
The first time I ever came to LA, someone Leslie and I both know when we were teenagers took me cruising and then we went to Amoeba.
And they went dumpster diving.
Yeah, and I bought an Amoeba baby tee, which
you
I then
did?
Cut even shorter.
Amoeba.
Bye.
Bye guys.